we're going to go ahead and get these babies watered down. Make sure the girls have a lot of sugar so they get nice and drunk. They probably wish it was mead, but you know. What do you think, Gary?
That's good on that side.
So, generous spray. You just make sure it's like totally saturated and dripping. A one-on-one mix. And we'll go ahead and pop the top here on the can. This is basically what they've been feeding on for since they've been traveling. And we'll go ahead and spray down the tube and get them nice and drunk again. From the inside out, queen cage is going to come out. Don't want to drop her in because I don't want to reach inside this mess. And there we go. Little drunky, drunk mess. And I don't know what you usually, set that aside?
I would kind of see if you can't knock them to get those out, those loose ones off of there.
Yeah, like that?
Yep. There you go. And then make sure your queen's looking good.
Oh, she's looking pretty. Looking hang on, real hang on. Pretty.
Let me zoom in on her.
Okay.
Okay, I got the... All right, good.
All righty. So I think what I'll do is set her aside. And we'll deal with the mess of them all. Get them nice and drunk, because we're going to be shaking the crap out of them, and they're going to probably get a little ornery.
You going to pound the box down once?
Yep.
Good.
So we're going to just do this number.
No, do it the other way. What pound them straight down.
Oh, you mean like...
Yep.
Like
there this. You go. Now turn them sideways and dump them.
And once you get the majority of them inside, which pretty much... There we go. Go ahead and leave that box up. Get to our queen here. Get her released. Basically what I'm doing is taking this cork out of here. Just a small screwdriver will work. And I'm keeping an eyeball on her. And I think she is out. Hopefully she's in there.
Just kind of knock that on top of the frames and make sure that the rest are off and she's out.
Yep, she's out, so she's got to be in there. So we're going to go ahead and squeeze the batch over. Or should I just leave this?
I would leave those. I would leave those and just start filling in.
Fill them with trays?
Uh-huh, your frames.
And
just kind of let the weight of them, the frame, move them down.
Right. And the one concern here is you don't want to squish. There you go. Give them a little something to track to. You really are not very... hope the queen is in there safely somewhere. Thank you, Gary. Because we don't want to squish her, that's for sure. Otherwise, we're going to have a queen loss right off the bat.
All right, just leave that, Brian. I would recommend leaving that and just letting the weight of them, let them move out of the way, and we'll see that slowly drop down. Uh-huh.
All right. So that's what they've been sipping on. A lot of times they'll take and I'll punch. There's two little divots in the can or holes. See how that's weeping? It's like three holes in there, and that's what they've been sucking on is that syrup. Because we're full of syrup inside of our feeder tray, that's probably not necessary any longer. So it doesn't spill all over. When you're transporting it in your car, make sure you have something containing this when you have it. Otherwise, you'll have some sugar seep out of the side, too. That's I found that to be... kind of a pain, but just set the cage down in front of where the entrance is, and they'll sniff the queen out and figure it out. they'll get back into it. See, we have, I got everything that's in here. So basically we're just waiting for this to come down, huh?
Yeah, and you know, in the meantime, them outer frames, I would squirt that with that sugar syrup. That way the bees can start working on that foundation.
Are you talking out here?
Uh-huh.
You know, I don't, I didn't do that before, and that's a good idea. Gives use for the syrup. Keeps the girls. Happy with food. Yeah, I didn't do that. That's a good idea. Do they say you should do this about like the day before too, right?
That's what they say. I mean, so, you do whatever you want, but I think it definitely attracts them to that foundation. You don't have any flyers at all, which is great, probably because of several reasons, working fast and
and it's
cool weather.
Cool out, about 40, 45 or so, which is good. One thing I noticed about this Brushy Mountain, this filler tray is real thin. It only took about 3/4 gallon instead of a full gallon. So one of the drawbacks, I think, with, not that I'm trying to Brushy Mountain bash, but yeah, come on, girlies. I think last time I had to just like put the cover on.
You're getting closer.
Yeah. Once they get climbing up, out of the way.
She's just sticky.
Yeah. We got quite a few in that pocket down there.
And what you might want to do too is just take one out and then later on tonight,
put that one back in. That's a good idea. That way we can kind of move it around and get some space going. There we go. There we go. Actually, actually, let's take the tray and just put it in. I think we're there. Yeah. She's gonna come taste you.
You want the top?
Let's get that tray. We'll stick that tray in. I got enough room for a tray right here.
All right. How you want your cover? Yeah, that's perfect.
Yeah. So we'll go like this. Like this. I leave it so you're gapped here and gapped here, right?
Yeah.
So that's what you want, is even distribution in the center. Yep, go ahead and...
I don't know how you want your cover.
Well, that's a good question about whether it's this side down or this side down, right?
Uh-huh.
I always go like this because the flat side to go down. Is that what you do?
I do the other way.
Do you do it the opposite?
It's really up to you.
Well, I don't know. Maybe that's good. We'll try it. I know the entrance will come out just as one here, so it's not like it's a big deal. I mean, it's slotted on both ends, so either way it's going to happen. All right, so hopefully we got a good queen, and hope for the best, all right?